standing up on Ben at the blue line. That's a heads-up play.
Miller scores! Colin Miller gets his first in the National Hockey League, and the Bruins are back even. A minute and 28 seconds between goals.
And what a nice response. The Bruins have done a nice job, Jack, in the offensive zone winning faceoffs. And it's been mostly Spooner that's been able to do it. It's about his third of...
Back in, but not a whole lot further. Then Marchand gets it back to Tarnik, then across. Score! Colin Miller with a blast with 2 seconds left on the power play, and the game is tied at three.
Well, Patrice Bergeron was out of gas. He was looking to give this puck to somebody. And all of a sudden, now the Bruins have fresh bodies on the ice. Look at the effort by Brad Marchand. He stays with this puck, gets it to Zarnik, and then Colin Miller goes top shelf. Again, defensemen being involved in the offense for the Bruins. Get them back in this game, tied up at three.
And another open body down low in front of Braden Holt.
Hollow, a little touch pass back to Miller. Working around the umbrella to Braun. Miller, one timer, scores! Colin Miller let it rip from out high. He ends a 13-game drought, and the Golden Knights end the power play drought. It's 2-0.
Good puck movement all around. They started early on this power play. Perron took a shot. Just getting that shot through opened up some of those plays to move the puck around. Neil missed off the goal line. Good movement into that pop-out play with Halla. And then Perron and Miller play catch. Miller blasts this one low to the blocker side. He beats Darling. His sixth of the year.
Marchessault wins this draw. Miller with a drive and he scores! Right off the faceoff, Colin Miller with a blast! And the Golden Knights have tied it!
What a shot by Miller as he puts everything into this one. A bang-bang play right off the draw. And Miller now goals in back-to-back games. Marchessault's gonna win it right back. Little D-to-D Schmidt to Miller. And he just tees this one up and blows it past Bobrovsky. And he rips this one-timer right in.
It's a crushing loss as they try to stay in the playoff race in the East. Here's Colin Miller with a long wrist shot. Score! And puck had eyes from the right point, Colin Miller. And the Golden Knights within two with 1:05 to go in the second.
That is a huge goal for Vegas. Colin Miller does a good job taking this puck off the wall and just get it to the net. It hits something on its way there and gets past Keith Kincaid. Jonathan Marchessault was in front. A look at the shot from the point. And it's both Green and Marchessault.
Not a shot on goal in the first wave of this power play. Second wave for the Golden Knights trying to do better. Led onto the back, Colin Miller, and drives, score!
Colin Miller does a great job of pulling this puck off the wall. He's the guy that kept the play alive. Eric Halla gets it back to the point. John Carlson looks like he screens, and this puck goes directly in past Braden Holtby. Little bit of a screen there from Carlson on Holtby.
And you almost have to wonder if he didn't think Halla was going to redirect that one. Coming to the net, and Halla, who had 29 goals this year, doesn't get a piece of...
Staros, and now the Stars on the attack. Colin Miller scores! They break through here in the second, double their lead.
Colin Miller had that gorgeous opportunity early in the period when he hammered it high and wide. This time the first shot, Saros almost muffed it. The second one blasted through the thicket of humanity in front of Saros. How are you supposed to trap?
To Johnston. Settles, leaves, Miller. Shot, he scores! Speaking of on fire, Colin Miller's got his third goal in the last five, and Dallas has a 3-0 lead.
He's been beating beating some netminders with just pure sizzle. This is almost identical to that Hockenpah chance back in the first period. Wyatt Johnston takes the line, leaves it for the D-man coming, and this is a whip wrister that eats off Carter Hart. He has a good view of this and just beats
off a body in front. Couture shoots, bad angle. Meyer the rebound. Loose puck. Scramble in front of the goal. Where's the puck? It pops free. And Smith steers it off the end boards.
Plays and then they might want to take a look at. And you take one more look at it. Here comes the rebound by Meyer. Now, where does this puck and how close to the line does it get? Oh, my goodness. I don't think it ever gets there, but that is unreal stuff. Look at the snow, full snow angel, Colin Miller. Looks like Dominic Hasek right there. Marc-Andre Fleury makes a big save on Myers, coming over top, and there it is. Is it Merrill or is it Miller? I don't know which one, but they come together.
So the Bruins able to keep Tampa Bay from getting a single shot on that one. And this almost finds its way through Raskin over the line, but a save off the line, Colin Miller.
Well, the referee was in perfect position along the goal line, and he waved it off.
Yeah, the signal was washout, no goal.
Yeah, he had the best view. Yeah, this puck is a lot across the goal line, but not entirely.
Foligno gets in there to bump into Miller, and they whack away at it back in the corner. Still trying to kick it free. Do, and Buffalo takes it away. Steered up in the wing for Eakin.
Here we go.
Now we got a battle in behind the play. And going at it is Foligno and Miller. Miller and Foligno dropping the gloves and wanting to go at it. They got to get the sticks out of their skates. And they try to slip them to the side, but the linesmen get in there to break it up. Much to the dismay of the fans.
Yeah, and then myself here too, and probably yourself as well. This happened down in the corner. Watch this. He comes in, finishes Miller. But they stay together. They did this battle here. Until this puck moves up, there's Foligno giving him a shot. He's going to give Stroger a shot as well. And the two of them stay right together, right here. And they're hanging on to sticks. And then finally, they decide to drop the gloves. And away they go. Nick Foligno gets a couple over the top, a couple underneath right there. Colin Miller, before he was able to unload on him, linesman stepped in.
So they'll sit for a while. All of this happening, almost 2 minutes.
Redirects the puck, but he wins the race to the dots. No icing. Shen bangs Vetrano. Jimmy Hayes in to help out. And the puck squibs all the way through. Colin Miller with a tremendous hit just inside the Coyotes line on a buddy pass, and Burmistrov is on queer streak.
This sure looks like a great hockey hit at first blush. It's a great gap by Colin Miller. It's a good lateral move. It's timed well. It's not early. It's not interference. Just as Burmistrov was receiving this puck, Miller leans in with the shoulder. Unless this replay shows us something else, that looked like a real good hit.
Miller's going to the box.
Maybe it's just for the extracurricular after the hit, but unless we see something other than that, but this is not good for Bibistro. See if this replay will make us think otherwise.
Well, he certainly, Colin Miller was moving laterally, did not lift his torso or spring off his skates. It's body through body.
Yeah, he's not leading with the elbow.
He's not picking the head.
It doesn't look like he's targeting the head. I mean,
the shoulder does go into the head. There's no question that Miller's shoulder does go into the head, but